Have you ever wanted to remove the year from someone's date of birth in Excel and just have the month and day of their birthday? Or have you ever wanted to calculate someone's years of service based on their hire date? You can use that with some simple formulas in Excel. Once you learn how to use these, you'll be able to do things super quick and easy. Let's build on the report that we just formatted. We know that we formatted this report so that it would be easy to view electronically or printed, but let's do some additional formatting and add some formulas into the spreadsheet that will make the data even more useful for whoever it is that we may be creating this report for. Perhaps it's the CEO of the company. One of the things that we can do is click on the column for annual salary, and then make sure you're on the home ribbon, and then click on the dollar sign. This is a quick way to format those cells as a dollar amount, and you know that you're looking at a dollar amount. It's easier to read. It's easier to see that. So I like to use that feature. Another thing, let's go ahead and add a column. We're going to select column H and right click and say insert. We're going to add a column here. And so in next to the hire date, let's say we want to see years of service. And what we're going to do is we're going to use a simple formula that's going to calculate the number of years of service based on someone's hire date. So let's go here. Let's highlight this formula. And we're going to hit Control C to copy. Let me go back into our spreadsheet. We're going to double click in the cell, hit Control V, and then we're going to make sure that our cell reference is updated to the correct cell. And then we're going to click Enter, and there we go. You'll notice that it looks kind of funky. We need to change the formatting. So if we highlight the column and right click and click on Format Cells, we're going to change this to a number, and we want to see it at 1 decimal and click OK. And that way it's helpful because then we can see, you know, if someone's been here for 7.5 years, it'll say 7.5. So it's nice to format that cell as a number out to 1 decimal. And what I want to do now is copy that formula all the way down so it takes it all the way down. Now you'll notice that throughout, as I click on the cells, the formula is going to stay there, and you'll notice that the today function is within that formula. And what's nice about that is if you were to save the spreadsheet and close it and then open it back up later, whatever future date or time that you open this back up, it's going to calculate the correct years of service based on that future date because it's referencing the today function and it's calculating that number based off of the hire date. So I'm going to leave that just as it is, and I might format that, double click that so that it brings it into the center and it looks good. The other thing I'm going to show you is, let's say you have date of birth, and you definitely don't want to include date of birth on a spreadsheet that you may be sending to someone. But let's say that the manager does want to see the birthday. There is an easy way that you can go ahead, and we'll insert another column here, and we're just going to call this birth date or birthday. And let's go to our formulas, and we're going to remove the year from the date of birth. So I'm going to copy that, go back over here, double click, and paste. We're going to make sure the cell reference is referencing the date of birth column, which is P2. Okay. And there we go. It takes away the 4-digit year from the birthday. So now what we do want to do now is we don't want to leave that formula in there, because what it is it's keeping the actual birthday in there. So what we want to do is we want to select the entire column, and we want to right click and we want to copy. Then we want to come back up and right click and we want to paste special, go over to the drop down, and then come over here and select paste values. That is going to put the correct value in there. And as you can see now, the formula is gone and just the month and day of the birthday. So there'd be no way to reference back the actual birthday. Then we can highlight that date of birth column and delete it completely because we don't need it in there. So there you have it, an easy way to format just the month and day of someone's birthday.
There are several formulas in Excel that I find useful to use on a day-to-day basis, so I've compiled a list for you. You can download it from my website at SharonSmithHR.com. This download is going to cover several very, very useful and time-saving formulas for you. And these are formulas that you can use if, for example, you're not able to derive the information that you want to see from your HRIS system when you run the report. You can easily do this with these formulas in Excel. And they'll include things like being able to calculate someone's age from a date of birth, calculate the percentage difference between two salaries, remove leading zeros from an employee ID number, use the left and right functions and formulas, and even create a full name column from two separate first and last name columns. Subscribe to my channel and let me know what formulas you're using to make your HR life easier every day. Thank you.